Hello, this is Amethyst on Atari. Welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. We are in the Restful Watchman, and today I'm going to be reading How to Befriend a Goblin, which I found in Castle Bruma. How to Befriend a Goblin, penned by the renowned scholar of goblins, Entis Altus. Goblins are simple-minded creatures. Indeed, many view them as barbarians, incapable of thought and devoid of sentience. Cutting them down without thought or restraint, while goading them into attacking their farmholds. What few realize is that goblins possess a softer, intimate side. They are more than capable of friendship. In fact, I would argue that goblins can prove some of the truest and most loyal, innocent companions one could have. An intrepid goblin befriender needs only to think like a goblin would and cast aside their prejudices. So, how would I befriend a goblin? You are no doubt asking yourself. Well, allow me to provide the answer. First, you must be absolutely sure that you have cast aside any presumptions you have. Each goblin is unique, very much an individual, much like any man or mer. You must first come into contact with a goblin, of course. There are numerous ways one might go about this, but I will focus on only the simplest in this text. If you are lucky, you may come across a lone goblin wandering the wilderness. In this scenario, it is very easy to make a new friend. Simply walk up to them and initiate conversation. Of course, you may find this a tad difficult, especially since most goblins do not speak Cyrodiilic or any common tongue of Nirn. But you may come to understand the goblin and his or her personality instead via paralinguistic features. For instance, their mannerisms, their facial expression and gestures. Their forms and their meanings are not unlike our own. If a goblin smiles, you can safely assume the goblin enjoys your company. If the goblin frowns, you can assume with great equal confidence that it finds your company disarmingly droll and uninteresting. Figuring out mutually accessible methods of communication is one of the most underappreciated secret pleasures of befriending a goblin. Once your relationship with the goblin develops further, the time has come to establish mutual interests. Goblins, it must not be denied, are not composed of the same intellectual substance as your average Imperial, or even Nord, or any of the other most prominent sentient races of Tamriel, for that matter. But they are still capable of great many tasks and recreational activities. I had great luck teaching my best goblin friend, affectionately named Grimy Greenfingers, for the curious, how to play the common game of nine holes. Others have enjoyed success by partaking in other activities with their goblin companion, including fencing, daring feats of acrobatics, and even pipe smoking and skooma use. I would, of course, not recommend the latter two, as introducing your innocent goblin friend to such disgusting vices would be incredibly cruel. And, truth told, a drug-addicted goblin, its disheveled, limp form, reaching out and begging you for its next dose of sin, is not a pretty sight. Once you have developed your relationship, one must, as with any non-goblin relationship, set boundaries. Goblins are prone to becoming incredibly intimate with their friends, especially their human or elven friends, most likely because they view such a relationship as a great accolade and honor. One must always designate an appropriate amount of time for socializing with their goblin friend, and be mindful of limits. If your goblin friend seems to be getting clingy, I would urge you to reconsider your time allocation and disciplinary techniques. A few stern words and a slap on the wrist may be appropriate for more severe cases. As an aside, I should also warn you that some goblins have been known to seek romantic relationships with their human and elven friends. If this situation is thrust upon you, I would urge you to decline. As I have learned from personal experience, romantic relations with goblins tended not to end well, both physically and emotionally. I do hope this tome has been helpful to you, aspiring goblin befriender. I wish you many happy adventures and memorable moments of happiness with your goblin friends in the years to come. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. How to Befriend a Goblin. Friends.
They're like fresh-born Achar. Pretty to look at, but not a use on Nirn. It couldn't be. Go, search his home. I want proof.